It is time now to head into the chat room, and joining me today is Nine's Dougal Beattie in Melbourne and NBN presenter Gavin Morris in Newcastle. A big welcome to both of you. Happy Monday.
Good afternoon.
First up today, scientists are concerned that our over-reliance on technology like Google Maps or sat-navs could lead to a rise in dementia because our brains are unstimulated for long periods of time. Look, as well as sat-navs, we also have technology that reminds us of birthdays, phone numbers, shopping lists, it goes on. Dougal, do you think our reliance on technology means we're no longer thinking for ourselves?
Totally agree. I reckon the first time I noticed this in myself was probably doing my Year 12 exams, maths exams. We used to whip out the calculator and just plug in 10 plus 4 equals 14. Like, you just are so reliant on it. Google Maps, another example, totally ruined me as well. I'm obsessed with learning which route is the fastest destination I've got to go to. Like, this way 6 minutes faster, we've got to go this way. And then I'm just following it, like, blindly through the back streets. I don't know where I'm going. My mind has gone to complete mush now. I reckon I've got my attention span's gone instantly. I open up my phone these days and I need to do something on my phone. I open it up and then something distracts me. I'm on Instagram for like 5 minutes scrolling through. And then I forget. And then I forget what I'm meant to be doing. I'm like, I opened this phone up for a reason and I can't remember what I've done. I reckon I can remember 5 phone numbers by heart anymore. I used to remember about a million mobile phone numbers,
too.
And you could just reel them off, but now they're all saved in your phone. I think we're stating the obvious that we're now relying so much on technology, and we just aren't exercising our brains enough, and there is probably a good argument to put them down every once in a while just to give your brain a bit of exercise.
Oh, I love it. I also think it's great. Like, I use my notes section for shopping lists. Facebook tells me when everyone's birthday is. My sat-navs tells me if I can get somewhere 2 minutes faster.
That's important.
The adage, use it or lose it, seems a bit appropriate here. What do you think of it?
I absolutely am. Look, this reminded me of a story that I read around about a year or two ago about the overall decline of the IQ average on a global scale. During the 20th century, it actually constantly increased. But over the last couple of decades, for the first time in history, it's been decreasing. And there's a couple of ways that they've measured that. I won't go into it. But there seems to be a direct correlation to the birth of Google around the mid-90s it came in. I still remember the first time that I Googled something. They said, what do you do with it? And I said, I'll just ask it a question, anything, and it'll answer. And, you know, it's been phenomenal. And everything that you guys just talked about, we've all done and we're all doing. I mean, we used to have the Gregories or those roadmaps, and you used to have to memorize your way to the destination. Mm. The phone numbers, I still remember my childhood home phone number, 49662868. I mean, that was my phone call to heaven. You know, that Mum and Dad, come save me. I don't know any other phone numbers anymore.
I don't know. My memories might be getting worse, but I reckon we're less stressed. I used to get lost all the time when I had to follow a map, all the time, and it was so stressful. It would take me 3 hours to get somewhere. It should have taken 40 minutes. Like, I love that there's technology that's helping us now.
Yeah, but I don't miss those huge directories that you used to have to carry around in your cars. I mean, you can just chuck it in and go.
We have to move on, but staying with the theme of technology, Woolies stores are deploying robots to monitor self-service checkouts to make sure no one is stealing, as well as, of course, making the stores safer. Gavin, are you comfortable with this Big Brother technology watching you when you shop?
Oh, you have to be comfortable with Big Brother, I'm afraid, because you are being watched the moment you walk down the front driveway, probably of your own security cameras, let alone the neighbour's security cameras. You jump in the Uber, you jump in the cab, you're being filmed and recorded the entire trip. As soon as you walk into the supermarket, they're taking photos of your number plate, and they know what kind of shopper you are before you've even stepped foot in the shopping mall. Everything is aligned. I just wonder, how far off are we before supermarkets become the first place where there is no human interaction, that everything is done on a phone scan, all of the shelves stacked by robots, and obviously the whole checkout process is something that is completely done by your own. The only thing that drives me incessantly insane are those waits. You know how you've got to scan it and you've got to weigh it? You can't put it in the bag, otherwise the whole system shuts down. The bag on the floor.
Just quickly, what do you think of robots?
You've got to be comfortable with it now, as Gavin says. I reckon those self-service checkouts, so many people can steal from them, right? Like, they're so easy if you wanted to, and they must be losing millions of stock. So I don't think an iPad just above that, just a bit, let you know that you're being watched. As long as it can't see your pin pad, I don't have a problem with it. But that vision that was rolling around before, or that image of that little thing that rolls around the supermarket saying that I pick up spills, what the heck is that? That's the weirdest thing I've seen going around. We don't need a... Can't someone just bring it in like the old days?
I don't even use the self-service checkouts. I still like to be served by it. I don't like doing my own groceries. Oh, totally old school. Studies found that men with beards carry more germs than dogs. In fact, every beard sampled had bacteria in it, and half had bugs that were hazardous to human health. Gav, this is disgusting. Maybe not surprising.
It reminded me of my dad. My whole childhood was, Dad, you've got food in your beard. Son, it's okay, I'm saving it for dinner. Hey, there's some things that really pay off. At school, I was constantly teased. You know, I had legs like an Olympic cyclist. They were so shiny. I still can't grow a beard. Finally, something has come in my favour.
There you go. After hearing this, most girls would not want anyone. I don't know. Why don't, maybe they would. Dougal, does this put you off growing a beard?
If the news director would let me have a beard, I would be there in a heartbeat. And long Jesus hair flowing, it must look magnificent. I probably have a patchy beard too, and disturbingly a few flecks of grey in there as well, which is I've only just noticed now. I used to live with a big bearded mate of mine. We're in our early 20s at uni. And in the morning, he'd walk into the bathroom and just rub his beard like that over the sink, and it would just be a forest of hairs and fall down into the basin. You just walk in afterwards and go, what happened in here? The concerning thing about this is the hipster joint. So if you're getting your coffee with those blokes with those huge beards, imagine going and having your latte and just a strand of beard hair is floating there in the foam.
I'm going to think about that every time a man with a beard gives me a coffee now.
He needs a beer net. So we know how they've got those beard nets. That's what they really need, and that will take the glam look out of those hipster joints. But in fairness, probably you'd find more germs on your hands if you did a swab of them as well.
Good
so,
point.
You know.
All right, lastly today, Americans spent the equivalent of $55 billion Aussie dollars on spontaneous drunk purchases last year, up from $42 billion the year before. Now, apparently men are more likely than women to drunk shop, while millennials spend the most. Dougal, have you gone on a buying spree after one too many?
The only drunk pursuit I've only gone on is probably in the search of the perfect souvlaki, I reckon. So sometimes I've been waking up and there's just been this garlic taste in my mouth, and I know that it has happened. But I've only spent probably about $20 drunkenly. I've never felt the urge to go into the shop, try on a pair of jeans and go, yep, I'll take those
babies.
What
about online shopping? You're never in bed and you get online and you're like, all those ads pop up. Oh, my God, this story speaks to me. I do this all the time.
Yeah.
And I wake up and I'm like, what? Or parcels arrive. I'm like, I don't even remember. When did I order
Hello,
that?
Hello, Amazon.
Gav, we're almost out of time. Does this research surprise you?
Not at all. 50 million of that was spent at 7-Elevens on the way home. What about combining being drunk and your tourist shopping, and you buy that outfit, you're in Holland, you go, a pair of wooden clogs, definitely going to use those when I get home. You're in Arabia and you go, oh, that white tunic, oh, it's going to be cool, it's fantastic, in the Aussie sun, it'll be fantastic when I get home.
That's funny.
The Mexican poncho.
I think I went to Tunisia and I think I may have bought one of those. But
yeah, that's sitting in the cupboard, right?
I get sucked into this all the time, those ads on Instagram, they hear you talking, it shows up, and I lie in bed and I'm trying to wind down. And anyway, on that note, I think it's a girl thing. Thank you so much for joining us both on Chat Room.